Hello everyone, welcome to Quarrelsome Rhinoceros Stitches, episode 8. Today is Wednesday, March 15th, and I'm coming to you from Maine, which is in the very northeast corner of the United States. Yesterday we actually got hit by a pretty big blizzard, left us with over a foot of snow. Some of the drifts were actually up to my knees. Because of the wind, it blows the snow around, so like at parts of our backyard it's not that deep, but up by our house it got blown up against the house. Anyway, so I've got some things to talk about today. I've got some works in progress, and I wanted to show you a couple of things that I did show last time, but the last episode's lighting was pretty bad, and I didn't know if you could actually see any of it. So I figure we'll just get right in. I also have a couple of acquisitions. And actually, here is my co-host. This is Kelsier. He's not usually very awake when I'm doing these podcasts, but it is just after lunchtime here. So, yeah, so let's get right into it. I actually don't have any finished objects. I did not get as much knitting done as I really wanted to this time. Which I'll talk about when I'm finished. I'll do sort of after what's been happening in my life kind of section when I'm finished. Let's see. So the major thing that I've been working on are my two test knits for the Woods Making Stories pattern book. So I am doing two test knits for them. I'm doing the Abisko socks and the Black Forest cardigan. And their crowdfunding actually I think ended the other day, and they met their goal and then some. So yay, congratulations guys, I'm so happy that you guys made the funding goal. So I can't show you the actual... What are you doing, honey? I can't show you the actual sweater, but I did think I showed this last time, but you might be able to see the colors a little better with my new... I have a new camera, so you may be able to see the color a little bit better. So this is the... there we go. This is... should have done this before I started recording. It is Cyrano de Rerum Natura. It is a French yarn. It is 100% merino. This colorway is called Plume. I really like the yarn. I love working with it. There's a little sample that I put on my little bulletin board here. So I really like working with it. It's really fluffy, and it's so squishy, and it is really fun to work with. So I'm still really enjoying that. I split for the sleeves, and I'm working on the body part right now. I'm hoping to have that finished within the next week or two. And then I haven't cast on the second sock yet. So I'm finished with one sock, and actually, I will show you that. I won't show you the pattern on the sock, but I can show you the yarn at least. So there's that. Yeah, so it's a Finnish wool, and it's very woolly. It's very sheepy. Which is great. I love it. And then here is the... It's called Tuku wool. Yep, 100% Finnish wool. And this is the color Joku, J-O-K-U, which I'm not sure what that stands for. But anyway, it is... I'm hoping to cast on the second sock here pretty soon and get that just quickly off my needles. And then I still have to weave the ends in on the first sock, but that shouldn't take too long.
All right, so moving on to personal projects, projects that I'm working on because I want to. I have two socks on the go right now. So I have Mina Philip, the knitting expat, has a New York Sock Club collection, so she's releasing 7 patterns, one each month for the rest of the year. And I purchased her mini heel flap adjustment, her vanilla sock pattern. So I got a discount on the pattern collection. So I went ahead and bought those, and so I am knitting the first one in the book, which was released March 1st, and it's, I think they're called the Grand Central sock pattern. So it's this really lovely textured, so last time I showed this to you, I had just finished the cuff, I think, or like just started the cuff or something. Anyway, so there is that sock. I have turned the heel. I'm working down the foot now. And this is actually way longer than any sock that I've made in the last little while, so. But yeah, so this yarn is one lupin in, it's their hand-dyed sock. I don't know if they have like an actual name for the base, but I'm pretty sure it's a merino nylon base, probably 80-20. And this colorway is called Kelp Garden. And the cake is a little messy, but I'll show it to you in the cake as well. So it's got these lovely pops of light blue, dark blue, light green, and dark green. It is so gorgeous. And I've been wanting to use this yarn for something, but I didn't feel like knitting a plain vanilla sock. And this has just enough textured pattern, so like that's the front of the sock. And it has just enough textured pattern to make it interesting without overtaking or the variegation doesn't overtake the texture, so that's good. And yeah, so I've got a little stitch marker on there that I got from a friend. It's actually a progress keeper and stitch marker, so like that loop you could put around your needle, or you can stick it in as a progress keeper like this. So that is one sock, which I am keeping in my Hennelisa Haferkamp bag. This one was a collaboration with Ovis Etc, so it came with this bag and two 50 gram skeins of Ovis Etc's Herba base in mustard and new jeans, and I made a hat with the yarn. Anyway, so there's that. So I'm keeping that in there. I'm actually also keeping the other pair of socks that I'm working on. So I'll bring up more of what I bought at this store in acquisitions, but I went to the local yarn store at my grandmother's house while I visited her, and I found my first ever Regia yarn. So this is the Arnie and Carlos. This one is color 03655, which is Fall Nights. So it's got this lovely pop of orange in there. Anyway, so this is what it's looking like so far. I haven't gotten very far on it, obviously. But I really like this yarn, actually. I am working with 64 stitches on a 2.25 millimeter needle. And I really like how it's turning out so far. I really, really like that pop of orange. It happened right here. I really like it a lot. And, I like working with this yarn. It's pretty cool. It's pretty good. It's in 75 virgin wool, 25 polyamide, which I believe is basically nylon. And I forgot to mention that these socks are on my Chowgu fixed circulars. They are a 2.75 millimeter, and I think I'm using 56 stitches. I'm actually preferring using a US2, which is the 2.75 millimeter needle for socks lately. The Cosmic Wonder socks that I got from the yarn that I got from Green Lambkin. I did those on a 2.75 millimeter, and I liked it a lot more, I think, than I like the smaller, with more stitches. excuse me. Yes, so, the next thing I will show you, I don't know if I've made very much progress on it since I last showed it to you, but I am working on the Koru cardigan, which it has taken a back seat because of the test knits that I'm doing, so I'm not really sure how much extra I've gotten done. I may have done one or two rows since I last showed it to you, but it's got this lovely twisted stitch pattern up the side of it. So this is the right front side, so it'll go up to here, and I've already finished the left front, and I'll work on the back next, but yeah, so I'm not sure how much of this I've gotten done since last time, but, I'm still really enjoying the yarn, and I'm really enjoying the pattern. I just haven't had a chance to knit on this one much. And my last work in progress is, I'm holding in my Mrs. Brown's bag that I got in the mail very recently. I don't remember if I showed it to you last time, but it's got this really pretty purple, it's like a canvas bottom. I don't know, it's really pretty, I like it. Anyway, so in this I'm holding my Hallibop. I'm gonna go with that. Hallibop mystery knit along. I am almost finished with clue number two. Clue number four is already out, so I probably won't end up finishing this in time for the knit along that's going on with it, but I am, and I can't actually stretch it all the way out, so I'll just show you from the middle. So clue one ended at this first lace section here, and then the last time I showed it to you, I was somewhere in this garter section here. So I finished the garter section, and I finished another one of the lace repeats, and I'm working on now one of the slip stitch repeats. So another one of these sections here. And then after I'm done with this section, it'll be the next clue. So I'm really enjoying this still. It's got, I won't say too much about it, it is a paid for pattern, but this is an I-cord edge that you do, so you, that you do as you work the shawl, and it's really, really neat. And I assume that means that you'll do an I-cord edge bind off, but anyway, I really enjoy, how finished it looks up here at the top. Like, you don't have to do any kind of border or anything up at the top to make it look finished. So, I'm really enjoying this shawl. I'm really excited to be able to wear it. So I'm hopefully gonna get some work done on that today. Maybe I'll finish up this section so I can move on to the next clue. I guess I should have said spoiler alert for those people maybe working on it, but I feel like since the fourth clue was released this week and I am still on the second clue, I feel like that's a little bit, that's fine. I am doing this, this is all Knit Picks yarn, so I've got the Stroll Fingering in the Dove Heather colorway, and then I've got, this is one of the Stroll Tonals, but I do not remember what the name of it is. It's definitely something. yeah, I can't remember what the name of it is. And then this one, the whole point, I guess, of the shawl, the whole reason I'm knitting it is because I wanted to use this yarn here, which is the Hawthorn in the Blueberry Speckle, the Hawthorn Speckle in the Blueberry Speckle colorway. So it's got these really dark blues and then a really light blue kind of speckle, and it's really pretty. Yeah. Anyway, so that's what I'm using for the section that I'm currently working on. so this, I just love how it knits up. I really do. Yeah, so, excuse me. So now that I'm done talking about, works in progress, of which I actually thought I had another one, but oh, I guess maybe my blanket, but I haven't worked on that one either. So I'm going to move on to acquisitions. And then I'll talk a little bit about what I've been doing this week, these last 2 weeks, and then we'll be, I'll let you, you can be free. Run, fly, be free. So I visited, like I said, the local yarn store near where my grandmother lives, in Belfast, Maine, and, yeah, so I bought, again, I bought the Arnie and Carlos Regia. This is the second ball of it, for the other sock. Not that interesting. they also had on sale the Madeline Tosh Chunky. This one is in the Mill Pond colorway. Just gorgeous, gorgeous green. I'm probably gonna try and make this into a hat. It's 100% merino wool. So, I think I'm gonna make this into a hat, maybe a cabled hat, because it is, the yarn is so solid, the color is so solid that I think that it would make a really good, cabled hat. So if you have any cabled hat patterns that you think are great, let me know, because I haven't really found very many that I like too much. I haven't really done a cabled hat recently, so I'll need, yeah. Anyway, it's chunky weight too, so if that makes a difference. Anyway, so there's that. I really enjoy, this is my second Madeline Tosh yarn, and I really love how soft they always are. And I also bought this one, which is, it's from a company that is based in Maine, and I actually just started following her on Instagram, and it's On the Round. It's in her Everyday Fingering base. This one is called the Speckled Cosmic Rainbow, and it is absolutely gorgeous. I absolutely love this yarn. This is probably going to become a sockhead hat for myself. It is superwash merino wool, and oh, it is, ooh, yeah. So this is probably gonna go into a sockhead hat, most likely. I am so excited. I just love how wonderfully speckled it is. Like, I love this purple and blue section up here. I love the green. I'm not a huge fan of reds, and I just love the whole thing. So, yes, so On the Round, she's definitely on Instagram, and I've really enjoyed following her since I bought this yarn. So, new indie dyer, I'm really happy to have found them, especially because they are based in Maine, and I really like, supporting local artisans. excuse me. My grandmother actually bought, these two, skeins of, it's cotton, bamboo, nylon, and silk yarn. And she wants me to make her a pair of socks out of it. And I haven't ever made socks out of anything other than merino, so, or well, or wool. So we'll see, but it's this really pretty, it's blue and green and gray. I don't know if you can pick up the gray in there. Yeah. So it's Kobasi by Hiku, I think. Yeah, so it's 55% cotton, 16% bamboo, 21% elastic, nylon, and 8% silk. And yeah. So, there's the back of the tag. Yeah, so it's color 811, Seattle Sound. And so she bought two of these, they're 50 grams each, so I will be making a pair of socks with these at some point. So I'll give you my thoughts on it once I do knit with it. It is pretty elastic, so I may end up doing a 56-stitch sock or a 66 sock instead of 64, which is what I would normally do for my grandmother. Anyway, so there's that. She bought those. And then last but definitely not least, I bought two skeins of Homestead Plymouth yarn. So it's from the Plymouth Yarn Company Incorporated. It's the Homestead yarn in this lovely, what is the name of this color? I found it at one point, Merlot. So this one is Merlot, and it is just gorgeous. And there's the tag. And then I also bought a skein of the same yarn, but it's Homestead Tweed in the charcoal color. So there's that. So these two are going to be something together, I think. I may use this to make either a small scarf or a shawl, like a mini shawl, a shawlette, I guess. But I haven't decided how I'm going, like if I'm gonna stripe them together or if I'm just gonna like color block. I don't know, I haven't decided yet, but, and I'll probably make up the pattern myself. So this may be, may keep an eye out on that, on my Ravelry for that. I also forgot to mention that I'm on Ravelry and Instagram and all of that. Anyway, I'll put them, yeah, anyway. Yes, I can't tell what weight this is. It looks kind of like either a double knit, a DK, or a, worsted weight. Let's see. It's 5.5 millimeter needles, US 9, so I'm gonna guess, the way they got gauged was with a US 9, so I'm gonna guess it's either an Aran or a worsted weight. Yarn. So I'll probably either use a US 9 or a US 10 in order to do whatever I do with these. But I am really excited about these. They are soft. They are, let's see, 100% wool, and then this one is 90% wool and 10% Donegal, so that's the tweed. Yeah, anyway, excuse me. So that's all the yarny content that I have for you this time around. I'm going to move into the My Life section, which, so if you are just here for the yarn content, then thank you so much for joining me. I will see you again in 2 weeks, and share with you what I've been knitting since then. And if you are sticking around, then here we go. So the last time I talked to you, it was right before spring break, and I ended up going to my grandmother's house and spending about a week and, well, a little bit over a week there. My great-grandfather is 92 years old, and he had a little bit of a crisis, so he had to go to the hospital, and we were there for a couple of days watching over him, and he got diagnosed with influenza A, and then I ended up getting sick with influenza A, so that's why I've been coughing. I'm sorry why I sound a little stuffed up. I'm still sort of recovering. But yeah, so that's been my week. That's why I did not get as much knitting done as I wanted to, because I was just dead. I ended up, it came on really suddenly too, so it was like Wednesday I was okay, Thursday I kind of had a cough, and I started to feel like nauseated and a little bit like dizzy, and like my head just wasn't right. And then on Thursday night I had the fever all night and then all the next day, and my grandmother was like, we're going to the ER. So she brought me to the emergency room and I got medicine, and they diagnosed me with influenza A, and it felt like I was on like this assembly line. Like I had saw six different people in the ER. I never saw the same person twice, and it just they were obviously ready for the outbreak, because apparently a lot of people have been coming in with the flu. So my advice is never to skip the flu shot ever, because the flu is the worst. I'm finally starting to feel human again after almost exactly a week of being sick. But yeah, I don't recommend it. Don't skip the flu shot. Yeah, anyway. Because my grandmother also was exposed at the same exact time, but she got her flu shot, so she only had a cough, and I had the full-blown flu. It was awful. So I was supposed to come back home on Friday last week, and, I did not. I didn't work Saturday or Sunday, and Monday we had a training that I didn't go to, and I finally made it home on Monday, and then last night, yesterday, we got a blizzard, so we had to make sure that I was home before the storm hit. But yeah, so, whew, yeah, it's been a pretty hectic spring break. It hasn't really felt like spring, obviously, because our backyard is full of snow, but at least it's been a break from school. I haven't had to go up to campus since the beginning of last week, so that's really good. And this weekend, the reason I'm actually recording a day early is because this weekend is the Maine Science Festival, and I will be out of my house pretty much all day tomorrow, Friday, Saturday, and Sunday. Tomorrow mostly for homework, because I haven't gotten a chance to do that either. I'm almost finished reading Brief Wondrous Life of Oscar Wilde by Yuno Diaz. I'm almost finished with this book. I've got about 100 pages left, so I'm right here. And I'm actually, I really enjoy it. I really, really like it. It's very interesting. Yeah, so there's that, and that's pretty much everything that's happened to me lately. I think I'm going to go and rest my voice and try and get a little bit better by tomorrow so that I can feel like a real human while I live tweet the Maine Science Festival. So I will talk to you all very soon in my next video, which will be in 2 weeks. I'll be back to my normal Thursday recording schedule. So I will see you later. Thanks for stopping by.